Hello everyone, how are you? Hope you are doing very well. Welcome to our English class. Today we will make a quick revision. So we will cover page 122 and 129 from your journey, which is your small book. So if you are ready, let's start. Right now, please open page 122. Okay, let's check the question. It says, read each sentence, choose the missing word from the box. This is your box. It say write the word, then reread the complete sentence. Okay, let's check them. It say there are kinds of snacks and there are many helpful ones to choose from. Okay, there are so many kinds of snack. How can I say so many kinds of snack? So I can say numerous, right? There are numerous kinds of snacks. Good. So, numerous is the most appropriate one for this gap. What about second sentence? A of raisins is a good snack. You can grab them and go. How you can grab? To grab something, you are using your hand, right? So, if you want to grab something, it will be a handful of raisins is a good snack. You can grab them and go. Good job. What about third sentence? It say some people like snacks like pretzels or nuts. So they are salty or sweet. They are salty. Good. Some people like salty snacks like pretzels or nuts. A can make muffins and breads. Who make muffins? Who is doing this? A baker, right? A baker can make muffins and breads. So, let's check the last sentence here. It say, not only do bakeries smell good, but the items are to look at. So, they look like what? They look like so beautiful, right? So, the items are beautiful to look at. Okay, right now, let's check six sentence. Sliced cheese goes well with crackers. What kind of sliced cheese? Finely sliced cheese, right? So, next sentence. It say, there is nothing like a orange as a snack. You can eat it or squeeze it into a glass and drink it. Orange is salty, sweet, juicy. Which one is? A juicy, right? There is nothing like a juicy orange as a snack. You can eat it or squeeze it into a glass and drink it. Good. What about next sentence? A knife is a tool. The sharp edge could cut a child's fingers. A what? A difficult, a beautiful, a happily, a dangerous. Dangerous, right? Knife is a dangerous tool because you can cut a child's fingers. You can cut your fingers, so you need to be careful while using a knife. Next sentence. A is trained in using very sharp knives to cut meat. Who use knives to cut meat? Butcher, right? Good. A butcher is trained in using very sharp knives to cut meat. What about last sentence? It say, after your snack, smile and go on with your day. Smile. If you smile, you also happy, right? So, if you happy, how you can go? Happily. After your snack, smile and go happily on with your day. Good. Okay. If you finish this page, right now, please open page 129. First of all, it say, read the following letter, circle the misspelled words. So, we will check it for basic words, review words, and challenge words. So, let's start. Dear Marcus, my class heard a speaker today. Is there something wrong here or not? It's right or wrong? Something's wrong here, right? Which one is? Speaker. So, let's circle it. Speaker. How can I write speaker? Okay, let's check it and check 12. Speaker. So, I need to write speaker for the first gap. Let's check the second sentence. His name was Mr. Brown. It's right? Yes, it's right. He showed us pictures of different parts of the country. We saw a picture of a farmer on his farm. Something's wrong until here. Yes, which one is farmer? How can I farmer correctly? Let's check 8. Farmer. So I need to write farmer for the second gap. Okay, let's continue. I looked at the picture closely to see all the animals. Something's wrong? I think yes, right? Closely. How can I write closely? Right. Let's check. Closely. It's in 6 words. Closely. Okay, for the third gap, I need to write closely. Let's continue. We saw pictures of the Rocky Mountains. What a wonderful trip that would be. Okay, is there any wrong word here or not? Something's written wrong, right? Which one is? Wonderful. How can I write wonderful correctly? Check 13. Wonderful. Instead of first U, I need to write O. Wonderful. Okay, let's write wonderful for the next gap. Okay, let's continue. I'm hopeful that someday I will see the mountains. Something's wrong or all right? Something's wrong here, right? Let's check review. Hopeful. There are two L's here, but it should be there is only one L. So, hopeful will be my fifth word, which is written wrong. Hopeful. This is the right one. Okay, let's continue. Some of my friends were talking loudly. Loudly. How can I write this as correct? Okay, check second one. Loudly. So, let's write loudly for the sixth gap. Mrs. Garcia told them to be quiet. Mrs. Garcia is our teacher. How can I write teacher correctly? So, let's check fourth word. Teacher. Instead of U, I need to put E. So, teacher will be my next word. Mr. Brown answered all of our questions. He was very friendly. Something's wrong here, right? Friendly. How can I write friendly correctly? So, let's check friendly. So, we can see friendly in 11th and we will write it like this. So, it will be my next word. Friendly. This is the correct one. Let's continue. After the speech, we all went quickly back to our classroom. How can you write quickly? Something's wrong here. So, if you want to write quickly, let's check 9th. Quickly. Let's write quickly for my next gap. It say, I was careful not to bump into anyone on the way. Your friend Danny. Something's wrong in the last sentence. I was careful not to bump into anyone on the way. How can you write careful? So, to write careful, you will just use only one L, but two L's written here. In this question, so I need to write careful for the last gap. Okay, good job. Thank you so much.